We start with paracentesis at 7 o'clock with MVR. Then we inject air followed by trabeclizumab. At this step, the pupil constricted. Then I injected helium, followed by the other paracentesis at 11 o'clock. I tried to dilate the pupil with helium, then with intracameral injection. Then I made the capsulotomy by 27 gauge needle, followed by the capsular access by microlexis forceps. The capsule in children is highly elastic. That's why you can see that the capsule is trying to extend very easily. Controlled capsulorhexis at this step is mandatory. After completion of the capsulorhexis, I start immediately with the vitrectomy and adjusting the parameters to be acting like irrigation aspiration. I started by irrigation aspiration and removed all the nucleus and the lens matter. At this stage, I found out that the posterior capsule was opened because there was dehiscence in the posterior capsule before starting. So I did anterior vitrectomy immediately. The bimanual technique gives us advantage of removal of the vitreous through both openings easily. Then I inject triamcinolone in order to detect any residual vitreous, followed by anterior vitrectomy again. I try to remove any remaining vitreous and the triamcinolone that I have injected. Finally, I inject air in order to detect any remaining vitreous and to prepare for closure. I prefer to close with 10-0 microgram in order to avoid entering the patient again under GE. After burying the sutures, I test for leakage by fluoxetine and then subcontractile injection.